must tell you the story of Jonah. A really remarkable tale. A peaceful and humdrum existence he had, till one day he went for a sail. The weather were fine when he started, but later at turn of the tide, the wind started blowing, the water got rough, and Jonah felt funny inside. When ships started pitching and tossing, Joe tried hard his feelings to smother. At last he just hung his head over the side, and one thing seemed to bring up another. When sailors saw what he were doing, it gave them a bit of a jar. They liked to see trippers enjoying themselves, but thought this here were going too far. Said one, "Is there not we can think on to stop you from feeling so bad?" And Jonah said, "Aye, lift me over the side and chuck me in, there's a good lad." The sailor, he weren't one to argue. He said, "Happen you know what's best." So he picked Joe up by the seat of his pants and chucked him in as per request. A Grampus came up at that moment, and seeing as Joe were hard set, it swam alongside him and opened its mouth and said,
"Come in, lad, out of the wet."
Its manner were kindly and pleading, as if to say RSVP. Said Jonah, "I've eaten a kipper or two, but I never thought one would eat me." The inside of Grampus surprised him. For the first time he'd been behind scenes, he found accommodation were ample for one, though it smelled like a tin of sardines. They went cruising over the water, and Jonah were filled with delight. With his eye to the blowhole in Grampus's head, he watched ships that pass in the night. "I'm weary of watching," said Jonah. "I'll rest for a minute or so."
"I'm afraid as you won't find your bed very soft," said the Grampus. "I've got a hard row."
A whaleboat came up at that moment. Said Jonah, "What's this here we've struck?"
"They're after my blubber," the Grampus replied. "You best hold on tight while I duck."
The water came in through the blowhole and caught Jonah's face a real slosher. He said, "Shut your blowhole." And Grampus replied, "I can't, lad. It wants a new washer." Joe tried hard to bail out the water, but found that his tasks were in vain. For as fast as he emptied slops out through the gills, they came in through the blowhole again. When at last they came to the surface, Joe were reading his accident policy. He put down his reading and took a look out and found they was grounded off Wallasey. Said Grampus, "We're in shallow water. I've brought you as far as I may. If you sit on the blowhole on top of me head, I'll spout you the rest of the way." As Jonah obeyed these instructions, the Grampus's lungs did expand, then blew out a fountain which lifted Joe up and carried him safely to land. There were tears in their eyes when they parted, and each blew a kiss, a real big one. Then Grampus went off with a swish of his tail, and Jonah walked back home to Wigan.